And then is
it showing up on YouTube?
it's starting. It's in
Okay.
yellow, starting. So it should be green when...
I mean, as long as you can hit in the player and it's...
We are live.
Sweet. Welcome everybody. Adam Patrick Murray here with Willis Lai on the boards. Got no camera on him, but say hello, Willis.
Hello, hello everyone.
Hello. We're gonna play some Halo Combat Evolved Anniversary Edition that just landed on the PC. But there's gonna be a little bit of a twist. I have it hooked up to an eGPU. I'm testing the Asus XG Station Pro with a 27 Super in it, connected to a Dell XPS 15. 7590.
Nice.
That sounds right. And yeah, I'm playing with my Steam controller. I am still only using a Steam controller in my quest to understand why people love it. So let's see how it plays in Halo. I played a little bit of Reach with it, so I'm already kind of comfortable, but not so much with the Master Chief Collection. I do want to go in the controller configuration real quick. I downloaded the top one on the community, which is True to Basics. But also we got the Existential Egg. It's got a couple of them. I like Existential Egg stuff. Let's see. This brings the Steam controller in line with the Xbox unit. The right touchpad is fine. Trackpad aiming. Zoom and shoot layout. Sensitivity to 8. Separate set for menu. You know what the hell? Let's try this other Existential Egg one. How are we looking over there? We got people coming in.
We got a lot of people coming.
Oh, hello.
Hello
all.
Usual. Let's see. Ziv.
Hey
here?
Ziv. What's up,
here?
Ziv?
Got Max. Eskimonster.
Hey.
Big Al 268.
Is everybody excited for some Halo? And some Steam controller.
I'm excited to watch you play Halo.
yeah. Well, all right, let's, you know, I'll probably have to mess around with the controller configuration a little bit, but right. Let's just launch the Master Chief Collection.
With the Steam controller, Gordon's not going to be happy that you're using
a
controller.
Hey, no, the Steam controller is built for PC gamers in mind, so I think he's going to be fine. He's going to make an exception because... The Steam controller is for PC gamers. I did already run this a little bit just to make sure everything's running fine. So I kind of pre-configured it a little bit. I will show you that though real quick in the settings. Over to video, we got a native full screen at 3840 by 2160. VSync is off, so you get the little frame counter up here for from GeForce Experience. The frame rate is unlimited and the graphics quality is too enhanced. So all the dials are turned up to 11. Yeah. So let's, should we start from the beginning? No, actually, I'm going to resume where I picked up. I went through like the very basic beginning stuff of like, oh, hey, Chief, we got you out of cryo sleep. Why don't you look up? Why don't you look left? Test your shields.
Yeah. We need the action packs.
Yeah, I'm a little further in already. This has movement on the right thumbstick. Oh, this is going to be weird. Not sure how to crouch in this configuration. Is it on one of the... No, I don't think so.
Did you set crouch?
Yeah, it says it's on the left stick, but in this layout, the left stick is disabled.
No.
So, let's... gotta go into the controller configuration and see. Crouch is one of the back buttons. Okay. Nope, it's not working. That's weird. Let's see. Controller configuration. That's weird. It says it's mapped to one of the back buttons.
Oh.
Yeah, the A button is working, but not the back button. Or the other button. Hmm. Okay, well, let's try a different configuration then. Or... select binding for crouch. It's assigned to B. B is not crouch in this game. The joystick... okay, armor ability, left bumper. Let's... oops. Oh, okay, okay. So I need to do the thumbstick. Let's see. It's the left stick. Crouch left stick. There we go. Yeah.
Nice.
There we go. Steam controller. I gotta tell you, the default configuration is movement on the left pad, which I'm not used to. Usually I do movement on the left stick, so this is definitely going to get a little bit of getting used to. But I can say I already want the sensitivity up on the trackball, so let's... I think it says go into the configuration. Let's... haptics, digital settings, let's do...
Oh.
Wait, did you hear that? What the hell am I doing here?
Adam, we got some of our people on chat saying that the video's laggy and choppy on stream.
Laggy and choppy on stream. Let's bring it up on our phone, our handy dandy phone. Why don't you come play this for a second?
All right.
Yeah, why don't we switch places? Let me double check it.
Looks like I took a long day to stop smoking.
Hello, everyone.
I'm getting out of here.
Oh, so, haven't really played Halo in a long time. If anyone knows, I own a PlayStation 4 console, and I don't have a Xbox, so when I did play Halo, I was borrowing my cousin's Xbox.
Alright, so yeah.
I've never used a Steam controller before, too, so this is all a learning curve for me right now. Okay. How are we looking over there, Adam?
Yeah, let me change a couple things. It is not doing great. 1 second. See the problem. Right. Sorry about it. Hold on 1 second. Still figuring it out. Our CPU is getting maxed out here in the configuration that I have. So let's drop this down to that. Okay. CPU usage preset. Alright, so just so everybody knows, I'm trying to test this with OBS, and I have not fully configured the OBS setup yet, so give me a second.
Adam's working hard. He's on the job. Ooh. So when do I actually get a weapon?
Oh yeah, you don't get a weapon yet. You gotta go through this stupid cutscene. Alright, everybody... Oh. Wait, no, I'm gonna... Nope, can't do that. Captain Keys.
Good to see you, Master Chief. Things are...
All right, everybody, Master hold Chief. On one second. I'm going to cut the stream. We'll be back in a second.
We'll be right.
There we go. Okay, I think we're back in business. There we go, okay. Alright, so...
Those Marines could use some help, Chief. Do what you do best.
There we go, okay. I think we're back, everybody.
Back, we're back.
And it's definitely less choppy. CPU utilization is mitigated. The stream is back on my end. All right, cool.
Nice.
Everyone says it's much better. All right, let's do this.
All right, come take over. All right, give me a second. It's been a while since I played. All righty. Handing it back over to Adam.
All right, Wills, thank you for filling in for me while we had those technical difficulties. And sorry, everybody. Like I said, I had my OBS not configured properly, so I was pegging the CPU on our streaming machine, but I mitigated it, and it should be good now. But now that Willis has done everything in this game, I don't... don't remember what's going on. I do know I want to change the sensitivity.
Oh yeah.
Let's go up to 5 on both of these. Back. Save settings. Back. Oh, okay, that's better. All right. Actually, I might even want it more sensitive.
So I shared a little bit about my fond memory of when I first played Halo. What's everyone's memory of playing Halo? The first one.
Man, I had some friends at the time. Why is my right trigger not working? I remember playing Halo the first time. I had a friend who had an Xbox, and like all he did was play Halo. Like that's he literally just, it was a Halo machine for him. Mm. Why is my right trigger not working?
Oh yeah, it's a little...
What the? That is so weird. I'm not quite sure what's going on with that. I can't tell if it's the profile or what. So yeah, he was playing a lot of Halo. I remember playing it. I wasn't a huge first-person shooter back in the day, but it was cool. But I was also just like, I don't know, Xbox sucks. PlayStation's so much better. Dreamcast, actually. Dreamcast, that's...
You're a Dreamcast fan.
Yeah, huge Dreamcast fan. Anyway, I don't know. I didn't really end up playing it till later. I probably got an original Xbox around 2002, 2003. Like still while it was alive, it hadn't died yet. Mm. Or they hadn't moved to the 360 yet, but yeah. Got to play some of the classics. But man, I do remember. Oh, this button layout is weird. I don't like this button layout. Look at that X. Why would X be the light? Oh, they put it on the bumper? Oh, what? I don't know about this. Let me load a different configuration. Who did this one? Was this the existential leg one? Alright. I'm gonna do this one.
Christian Iverson said, the first time you enter the valley with snow, mind-blowing.
Oh, hell yeah. Okay, so this one puts the movement back on the right stick, or the left stick, I'm sorry, instead of the left pad. Oh, and I think this doesn't have haptics on it. Oh, it's also no trackball either. This is the fun part of Steam controllers, Willis. is going in and fine-tuning every single thing.
I know.
Let's see. Wait, am I in the... Nope, I'm in this one. Haptics. Oh, no. Haptics off. Wait, no. Where am I going? I'm going in this one. Trackball mode on, baby. Friction medium. Let's do haptics high. I like my high haptics. Friction low.
Now people are wondering, you know, why Steam controller over mouse and keyboard?
That is a great question. Well, I started in December. I started a little series where I was trying out the Steam controller and trying to understand why people love the Steam controller the way they do. So I promised for many months into 2020 I would exclusively use the Steam controller to try to understand why people love it. So I could do mouse and keyboard. I mean, I could do whatever. But let's be honest, I'm more of a controller person anyway.
Same here.
And so I have to... Oh, man. The button layout is weird on this. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not that dexterous with mouse and keyboard, so controller fits my gameplay style a little bit better.
Yeah, if you want to go back, look on the YouTube channel. I have... I talked about... Because, I don't know, almost a year ago now, I did a video saying... trying to tell people which is the best controller for PC gaming, because I was reviewing the 8-bit do SN30 Pro Plus that had just come out. Mm-hmm. And I was kind of positing, is it the best controller for PC gaming? And then I got a lot of people in the comments being like, why didn't you talk about Steam controllers? Steam controller's the best controller for PC gaming. And then I was like, what? Steam controller? People still use that? And then they went on sale at Black Friday. They went on sale for like $3. And I was like, all right, whatever.
$3?
Yeah, I was like, I'll pick one up for $3. And then immediately they said, hey, you know what? You know why this is $3? Because we're killing it. We're discontinuing it. And I was like, all right, I did an unboxing. When I got mine in, I did an unboxing and said, hey, I need people in the comments to tell me why they like the Steam controller, because I don't get it. You know, what should I do? And yeah, there was an outpouring of support in the comments that were, everyone was super cool, you know, and tried to help me understand why the Steam controller is awesome. And then my next video, I said, all right, cool. This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to exclusively use the Steam controller for a number of months. And then kind of report back my findings on it. Unfortunately, I haven't kept as strong to the initial promise. Sorry about that. I was supposed to do a lot more streaming. But yeah, we've had some stuff we've had to deal with here at work. I've also moved recently. So I have not been gaming that much.
Busy.
But things are starting to settle down a little bit. But I have not given up on my Steam controller quest to understand the glories of it. And you know what? I tell you what, I do like it. So far, I think I understand why people love it. I mean, like the PC, you get to really customize and get nitty gritty with your settings and like everything that it can do. So yeah, I still don't know if I'm going to stick with it long term. There's nothing like the classic Xbox controller for me on PC. I do love it, but I mean, I'm not hating it. I'm not hating it in my time.
Have you tried PlayStation controller with PC gaming?
I have, but it's actually not too bad. I think the biggest problem is that a lot of these extra controllers don't map the on-screen buttons. Oh man, I don't know where to go. Oh, B. Okay. Psh. Don't map the on-screen button prompts, so you know it wouldn't have the X square, triangle, circle, mm-hmm. whatever. So you kind of lose that. I know some games, like, the functionality breaks, like, either in rumbling or whatever. But, I mean, there's a lot of third-party programs you can actually load to make it work fine. Even use the touchpad. But, I mean, but still, like, the integration with the Xbox gamepad with PCs are just... It's just so deep. It's so good that, I love it. Especially the Elite. I have an Elite Series 1 at home, and then we have a Series 2 here at work. So, you know, if you're going to spend close to $200 on a controller, that's the one to get.
That's the one to get.
Actually, that's probably the only one that's... Well, no, it's not the only one that's expensive, but... The most ubiquitous one.
Yeah, what are the other expensive controllers we got out there?
It's not expensive, but one of my other favorite controllers, like I said, is that 8-bit Do SN30 Pro Plus.
Oh, yeah.
It's about 60, I think. Mm. So, you know, it's comparable with the other ones. I know SteelSeries makes a gamepad. I think Razer makes a specific gamepad, but they have the ones that tie in with mobile. Yeah, you know what? I guess there isn't one that's more expensive.
Mm.
Now that I think about it.
Like, how much was it? Like, hundreds something?
Well, the original one was 150, I believe, and then the Series 2 was 180. Look at these guys. I am surprised with my 2070 pushing 100 frames. I mean, it's a classic game. Hey, look at that. I'll switch back to the old graphics. This is what it used to look like. Isn't that crazy? We've come a long way. Also, it didn't even look this good at the time because, I mean, we're still running. It's upscaling to 4K. You know, When you first played with these graphics, you're talking 1080. Or no, not even 1080.
Not even.
Yeah, we're talking like 480 for most people, and then 720 for maybe for some people who could afford it. But I mean, I gotta tell you, the work they've put into these Halo games, I totally appreciate it. I have it on Xbox, but then I was like, you know what, have it on PC? Hell yeah, I will take it. I will take it. Okay. Look at these cutscenes. These cutscenes are definitely choppy. Yeah, I'm gonna skip it. So yeah, what people are people having fun? Are people reminiscing about Halo?
Yeah, people are. Yeah, all on the Halo chat.
Chief,
saying you won't miss us. Say, Mr. Seven. Digit right. Says you won't miss out on playing anything with this game on an Xbox controller.
Nothing we can do. Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, I mean, I honestly, I kind of am curious about the mouse and keyboard support for this, but watch this. You know what, actually, that skybox doesn't look too bad, you know, considering, I mean, it's low rent. I mean, look at that water. I mean, but still, you know, that's not bad. It's not until you get to the geometry, like, nearby. I mean, look at that. There's just, like, all sorts of grass, trees. Yeah.
That looks...
I mean, even... Yeah. Look at those textures. Those are blocky.
Those textures.
Yeah. Ah. Yeah, I mean, I bet mouse and keyboard support's pretty good. I, like I said, I played a little bit of Reach. I've tried the mouse and keyboard on it. It wasn't bad. I don't know, maybe turn off the light. I don't need a light. I do want. There's one thing I do miss in this. In these early Halos is a run. I tell you what, not having a run button in early Halos is. Whew. I like a good slow-paced game, but
sometimes you just need to get places.
Yeah, sometimes you just need to get places. That's right, Willis. Willis knows what's up. We haven't had the glories of Gordon popping in the chat at all.
No,
that's good.
Gordon.
I was worried. Well, he's unfortunately he's sick. Just some sort of cold or strep throat or something. I don't know. Not coronavirus. Don't worry about it. Elena's sick as well. So yeah, it's a little quiet around this week. No full nerd that was supposed to be scheduled. Yeah. But hey, health and safety comes first. So I was like, you know what? When Halo dropped yesterday, I was like, hey, this is a good excuse as any to play some video games at work, especially on this eGPU. You know what? Let me do the little game bar overlay just to see where the stats are running. I mean, look at that. The GPU's only running at half. It says GPU 49%, RAM 32, and CPU 30. So I will tell you, so I have the 2070 hooked up in here in the eGPU, and I've disabled the screen on the Dell. I'm actually running a DisplayPort to this monitor here and then HDMI to our capture and then just duplicating it. But yeah, I was definitely running into problems when I would also try to display... Like if I was outputting on the GPU and I was trying to display to the internal monitor as well, it would fire up the IGP. What Gordon thinks is that it's having to render the game on the card, but then when it comes back through on Thunderbolt, it has to use the IGP to display it on the monitor here. So like I was getting like crazy overhead. Like if I were to play this right now, I'd probably get like 20 frames a second just because it had that overhead of coming back through the IGP. So yeah, if I ever in this situation and I was at home trying to stream on or to play on my TV, I would definitely have to disable the internal monitor. I mean, not that I need it anyway, because I mean I should just be looking at my TV. But yeah, that was one thing I was not counting on. I thought maybe you could have like an extended display or something, you know, and kind of have some other stuff up at the same time. But nah, that overhead just kills performance. And I mean, honestly, I could, especially, you know, with this game, I could easily, I mean, we're like a 90s, I could easily put in a 2060 Super and still be fine in here. The laptop itself has a 1660 Ti, so I haven't really tried to play it internally. But one good thing that I haven't really reported to Gordon yet, he was wondering if I could test out, is that the CPU throttles pretty hard on these Dells when you're pushing both the CPU and the GPU at the same time. And yeah, I'm happy to report that because we're not using that 1660 Ti, it's literally disabled, that the CPU clocks stay super high. I was, you know, after a couple hour gaming session over the weekend, I was sitting there with, still hitting like 4.2, on all cores, not all cores, but you know, around 4.2. Where Gordon was saying that he's seen cases where the CPU would like throttle and drop to like 2.25, which is not great for gaming. Yeah. So I mean, temperatures, like I can actually put my hand on the laptop right now, and it's not that, I don't have a FLIR with me. That's Gordon's. It's definitely warm, but it's not like scalding hot like you can get on some of the laptops. So yeah, that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Does anyone have any hardware questions on this eGPU so far? I do plan on making a video probably in a couple weeks when I have a little more testing under my belt. I'm trying to get in a laptop with a 2060 Super in it, or even a 2070 Super, so that I can do direct one-to-one tests. My hope is to benchmark a couple games with an internal card, which is obviously a mobile part, but then do the same benchmarks with the same card with the desktop variant. Just to say, hey, you know, this is how much performance. I mean, because some people are saying that that I'm being constrained by the by 4 on the PCIe lane. So I want to know, you know, is that constraint not really worth it? Should you get a more higher end card in your laptop itself, or because you're still using a desktop card that's, you know, can hit higher clocks and has more cores, that you can say, hey, it's actually better to get a cheaper GPU and then get an eGPU. It's one of those tests I want to run, but unfortunately we don't have any laptops in right now that we have desktop equivalents of, so still trying to get one in, but yeah. Oh man, I don't know what melee is on this controller layout. Oh, there it is. B. Whoops. Wrong button.
Just wasted a grenade.
I just wasted a grenade. But they're about to drop my favorite. I love driving the Warthog in these games.
We got Peter Jensen here asking,
what's up, Peter?
Asking, what is the bandwidth of this eGPU?
Well, the...
They're coming in fast.
I don't... can you clarify your question? I mean, it's definitely PCIe 4. It, you know, going over Thunderbolt 3, it has to drop down to that. What's the button to get in? There we go. Nice. One of my favorite parts, driving the Warthog.
I remember my cousin and I were fighting over, you know, who's the driver and who uses the turret.
Yeah, it's funny. I've always just loved driving. I know, like, the turret's fun, but man, the driving, it's unique. It has that weird, like, you can just whip around. You get the physics going. Look how boring these corridors look. I mean, it's not like they look that much better, but whew. Warthog 2, let's stop for a second. Let's look at these Warthog assets. Oh, it's not very bright in here. Lighting. Woohoo! Did Peter clarify this question yet? Nope, that's not what I want. What is that back there? Actually, I don't know. Let's go look! Oh, it's one of those terminals. I forgot they added terminals to the anniversary edition. Yeah. Oops. I think I get an achievement or something for watching this. Sorry. Keep hitting buttons. Stop hitting buttons!
Into a cutscene.
Yeah, I remember they added these terminals. That's funny. Yeah, because...
So Peter got back and said, with Thunderbolt 3, does it fully utilize the bandwidth?
No, it will drop down to by 4. Or so I'm told. I have not confirmed, but I mean, that's part of the spec, according to Gordon. So yeah. What that means in a practical term, that's, you know, I obviously do not know as much as Brad and Gordon when it comes to the hardware and stuff like that. But theoretically, when you're running these cards over by 4, you should be bandwidth limited in certain areas. Which, you know, I understand from a theoretical aspect, but, I don't know what that means from a practical aspect, because, you know, I mean, this game is running, you know, pretty well. I think maybe what it also means is, you know, it's like, I'm only really using 50% of the GPU, so it's not like I can really push it any harder. Maybe that's what it means. Like, you just don't use... You can't top out the GPU. I'm not quite sure. That is above my pay grade. I am not the expert. I just work with the experts.
Gordon, if you're on the chat, please chime in.
Oh, you know, I...
Or Brad.
Yeah, I... I think despite the bandwidth limit, I mean, we have talked about it in a lot of theoretical ways, you know. Like I said, the whole idea of, you know, maybe skimping on the integrated GPU and spending some more money on the external. Here's a good case. We can talk about this. I'm going to talk about this in my later video, too. But we're getting new work laptops here. For longtime fans, know that when I started in 2015, we got work-issued MacBooks. But then we were able to build desktops. But the work-issued laptops have always been MacBooks. And so we've just pretty much borrowed review units or, you know, got samples to use laptops at trade shows, which is good because then we can review them and more thoroughly. This guy's just chilling at the truck. Yeah, you just wait here, man. Don't worry about it. But yeah, we got budget this year to get new work laptops, both Willis and I. And we really like the Acer Concept D7, which is great, but it comes in two variants. One variant for $2,400, I believe, is equipped with an i9. I think it's a 9980H. It's the same thing that's in here. Anyway, it breaks down, the two variants break down between two things. One is a 16 gig for RAM, the other one's 32 gig for RAM, which, I mean, I'd love 32 gig, but, you know, the price difference does not necessarily justify it. The other option is a jump from a 2060 mobile to a 2080 Max-Q. And that is a $700 difference. So for $700, you jump from a 2060 Max-Q to a 2080 Max-Q, and you get double the RAM. Like I said, while I would love 32 gigs of RAM, I can do okay on 16, that's fine. But that jump from a 2060 to a 2080, I mean, you're not getting that much for your money. That seems a little steep. So I was like, all right, what if you just got the 2060 version, which is actually what we're getting, and then spent that extra $700 on an eGPU, which I have this XG Pro or XG Station Pro from Asus is $300. So that leaves you $400 to get a GPU that you can swap out a desktop part. So does it make more sense to do that or to get the best, the best integrated part. So yeah. Unfortunately, we won't have the 2080 integrated to test, but we'll at least have the 2060, and we can pair it up against a desktop 2060. So, you know, we can at least make an assumption there, or, you know, we can have hard data there, and with that we can make the assumption of, okay, well, if this scales to a 2080 desktop card, this is probably what it's going to be like on the integrated. But, once again, I think the biggest factor is that, like, when you're disabling the integrated GPU, you're allowing all that cooling to go to the CPU, and even though you're getting less bandwidth on the by 4 lane, I feel like you're probably getting more theoretical real world performance out of better cooling on the CPU, and having the ability for a desktop card, because that's the other thing, is that a laptop, you can't really swap out cards, I mean, unless you get Alienware. So why not just go eGPU and kind of get bought into a desktop card?
All right, and when you're looking, you're doing some, you know, heavy research on the eGPUs, because also you mentioned you're moving, and it's also the lack of desk space, right?
Yeah. So where we moved to, it's a smaller place. I had a real big desk in the place I was at for 3 years, and it was nice. You know, I like having a desk, and I definitely miss it. But in our new place, it doesn't really work for how we want to set it up. My wife and I are both pretty minimal when it comes to setups and stuff. So we're like, all right, it's, you know, I'm fine not having, I'm fine not having a desk in this setup, because I think it's what's best for the space. Mm-hmm. But you know, I still want to game on a PC. What are my options? I mean, I There's plenty of people who've told me, you know, I should go down the small form factor route. But the problem is that, you know, without a dedicated setup, I literally have to set up the tower every time and a monitor and a mouse and keyboard. So I was like, all right, so that seems like a little much, even though I know I could still get desktop performance. That's great. But I was like, well, why don't I look into eGPU? That's the theory is that it's supposed to be, you just take a laptop, which are, like I said, I already had laptops that I've been using here at work. Take a laptop, get an eGPU, throw a desktop card in there, and off to the races. So, I mean, so far, I've definitely had some problems. That first laptop I tried out, the Lenovo, oh boy, that gave me a lot of headaches.
Blue screen, right?
Blue screens, driver issues. Oh. The games were trying to run. So, but that Lenovo was equipped with a Quadro, so it had workstation drivers alongside consumer drivers, which was adding to it. It was single channel memory, which Gordon definitely thinks it's adding to the problems. And then, yeah, I got games to work, but it was very game dependent, and I think it was because some games knew how to look at the driver or ignore the workstation driver and just focus on the game drivers. So, yeah. So anyway, that's why I borrowed this Dell from Gordon. I mean, it's got an 8 core in it. I mean, this is a pretty beefy machine. I'm not necessarily condoning, getting a Dell, but, you know what you're getting when you get this. It's a known quantity. It's, you know, one of the highest sold laptops out there. So, I think it's a good test case. And like I said, we're the Concept D7s. Willis is getting his first in, so we'll hopefully do some testing on his, and see how it goes.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, so yeah, you know, it's just like, okay, well, I need a laptop at home anyway. So if I'm doing that, you know, could I just be like, okay, I'm going to set up an eGPU on my kitchen table and already have, you know, a mouse and keyboard built in, but really, honestly, I'm just probably going to connect to a controller. So does that work? Does that work with my lifestyle? And so far it hasn't been too bad. I think the biggest thing is the size of screen. I used to use a 27-inch monitor at home. I have a 27-inch monitor here at work, and then going to gaming on a 15-inch monitor, it's harder. It's harder for damn sure. But I am sitting closer to it, in some ways, I'm kind of already accustomed to it just because I game on the Switch a lot, and that's a small ass screen, which I'm not happy about. I mean, at least it's bigger than the Switch, I'll tell you what. Yeah.
You don't dock it often, right? You don't put the Switch on the dock often.
No, probably about like 10% of the time that I'm playing it. Really, like it's a handheld device for me. I love handheld, so I'm pretty much always in handheld mode. I played a lot when I commute at home. You know, maybe Lindsay's doing something on the TV, so I sit on the couch and play my Switch next to her. It really works out. That's why I love the Switch. But we're talking about PCs here. Gordon would be so angry if he knew I was talking about
the Switch?
These damn consoles, damn child toys. Yeah, you know, honestly, I know this might be a little sacrilege, but this game's a little more boring than I remember. It's been a while since I played this. I know I'm in the early stages of the campaign, but I do remember a lot of it, and it's not the most eventful Halo out there for the time. Hey, cool.
And when developers, you know, make games that are a remaster, you know, how often do people, like, go back and play? Is it just for the nostalgia, or, you know, just because they actually, you know, updated the graphics and they just...
I mean, it depends. I mean, I think it's... there's a couple cases. It's like, man, if they... If Konami got their head out of their butt and re-released a remastered Silent Hill 2, say, or, you know, Metal Gear Solid or something, I would 100% play through that game all through again, even though I've beaten those games, you know, 1,000 million times. some games, what's a good example? Maybe there's some games that I never tried, and I was like, okay, cool, I'll try it for the first time because it came out and it looks nicer, because it's better than going back and trying to, you know, suffer through older visuals. Oh man, that is a big change. but then there's also curiosity things. It's like, was I ever gonna play Halo again until this came out? No, I mean, I've beaten Halo 1 so many times, but I am curious. I mean, that's why I wanted to load this up and be like, okay, well, what does it look like? How does it run? Does it hold up? That's definitely... It's a question worth asking. I think it makes sense. What's up, Luis? We're just playing some Halo.
Got Nando over here.
Yeah. Got our coworker, Luis. What's going on, man?
We have survivors and need immediate stop. Yeah.
So look at these graphics. Don't they look so good?
Oh, yeah.
Boom!
Oh, my God! What?
What?
Mind blown.
Mind blown.
Do it again.
Watch this. Oh, yeah. That's how you remember it, right? Good old days. Boom! In 4K, man. 4K grass. They added grass. Wait, what? Why are they... Am I supposed to go in there? How many times have you beaten Halo, Luis?
Four or five times,
yeah.
For Luis.
Like including the original version or this anniversary edition?
Anniversary edition.
Oh, okay. But you've been playing on an Xbox,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Oh, God. Look how much better it is on a PC.
Yeah, but this is not on a 55-inch. Super awesome TV.
It is definitely not on a 55-inch.
Super awesome TV.
Super awesome TV. No, you can do it now. That's fine. Yeah. We're swapping out drives in our NAS, and don't tell anybody, but our NAS lives here in the studio. Don't tell anybody, because it's the most climate-controlled room. What? How many people know the secret? I don't know if Willis knows that. Don't tell us how many people know the secret. Except for all the people who are in on the secret. They all know it with each other. Don't talk amongst yourselves that our NAS system's here. Though we are doing a pretty beefy upgrade. I'm excited about it. More storage space. Woohoo! Videos. They're getting larger. We're starting to do more 4K. We're actually on the cusp of buying new cameras as well.
Oh, yeah.
I will talk about that later. I want to switch out the camera systems because we're switching out the camera systems in here. I want to switch them out and don't tell anybody and just see if anybody notices. I think people would notice.
And yet they got to guess what camera we're using too.
I don't think they're going to
know. No.
They won't be able to guess that.
Have a guess.
Yeah.
Couldn't hurt.
Oh, wait, no. This is just where I came from.
Where are you going?
I don't know where I'm going. Let's see. There's nothing over there. I was going this way, following the yellow brick road. Okay, here we go. I'm going through here. Luis?
Yes, sir.
Is that sacrilege for me to say that this original Halo is kind of boring?
That's sacrilege, dude.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is that true? I mean, if there's a Halo I'm going to sit down and play, it's not going to be this one, right? Yeah, it'd probably be 3. Actually, or ODST. But probably 3. If I'm just going to sit down and play, ODST is if I want to maybe sip some whiskey and smoke a cigar. Man, I back in the day, back in my day, I beat them all on Legendary.
Back in your day.
Yeah. When this was only when this was only out on the console.
Can you ask people's ages, Willis?
I didn't say that.
Why are you asking my age, man? That's HR. Let's get HR on the phone.
Oh, no.
That is inappropriate. Actually, no. I beat all of them on Legendary except for, I should say, up through Reach. Reach was the last one I beat on Legendary. By myself. On Legendary. Yeah. And then when 343 took over, I mean, they're still good. I actually never even beat the newest Halo. Oops, don't tell anybody. Oh, I just got an achievement. I got Foe Hammer. Kill 5,000 enemies. I got 10 points.
Foe Hammer?
Oh, no. If you hear the beeping, just know that it's our very super secret NAS system. Nobody knows about it. Except for everybody here. Once again, we're in one of those spots where I'm kind of stuck. Wait, Willis, what are all the Halos that you've beaten?
None.
None? You've never beat a single Halo.
So, Luis said I can't work here anymore. So, good knowing everybody.
Wow. Yeah. See you later.
I only played Halo every time I just go to my cousin's place. And, you know, my cousin lives, you know, in, like, Daly City area. So, and I'm in East Bay. So, can't really meet up all the time. Yeah, especially when we're kids. So, every time I would go there, I was like, okay, you got Halo on? Okay, let's play that. And then we would just play a little bit. And that's it. Never got a chance to, like, see the ending or beat it. Oops. Maybe I should, you know. I should get it now on PC.
I mean, it runs pretty damn well, so. Don't mind the beeping. I don't think anybody can hear it. Do you think, Luis, what do you think? Do you think if Willis got picked up on PC, should he start from one? Just start from one and just pound through them all. You don't think he should start on Reach? The canonical, I know, right?
How many,
yeah.
How many Halos are out?
There's a lot of Halos. Well, part of the Master Chief collection is 1, 2, 3, ODST, Reach. Two versions of 2? Oh, you mean the anniversary? Well, but that's just a graphical thing. I wouldn't really count that. Because there's two versions of 1 as well, so... But I wouldn't really count that. Yeah, right. I would say literally start with release order.
All right.
And I mean, the first one, if I remember correctly, the first one's only like 6 hours, 7 hours, maybe. It's not too long.
Yeah.
It's not till later, I think, when I was just like, oh boy, they're starting to drag. Two was short. Two was like 4 hours.
4 hours? Oh, wow.
Well, great. I mean, it's probably more than that.
Right.
But, you know, if you know what you're doing, you can get through pretty quick. I forgot what the bash button was. Okay. Ah, where'd he go? Oh, no. Yeah, wait, so which ones have you touched, Willis?
That's a very good question. I don't even remember.
You don't even know. You're just like, hey, let's put on some Halo.
First one for sure. Okay. And then, what's the... Because we played a lot in like co-op couch, you know, like co-op mode.
Mm-hmm.
What's the one with the plasma blade?
Well, that's it. Starts with the second one.
The second one.
Technically, it's in the first one, but you can't use it.
Right. I want to say the third one.
Did any of them have smoky jazz music?
Smoky jazz music.
And it was raining instead of night.
Yeah.
Because that's probably my personal favorite one, and that's Halo 3 ODST.
Oh.
It was like a side story kind of thing. Well, on PC, you buy it once and it comes with it. Once it's released. They have not released it yet. God, ODST. Oh, I had so much fun with ODST. I loved it. Nathan Fillion. Why can't I hop in? Look, I'm like stuck right at the edge. I can get right on the lip, but I can't go in. Hey guys. Oh, nice hat. Look at those face models. In both cases, he has resting bitch face. Wait, where's the other guy? Who are they waiting for?
You.
Where am I supposed to go? I don't think I get on this one, do I? Am I at the end of the level? I don't think I get on this one. Oh, yep, no, they're taking off without me. Where did I leave my truck? Oh, look, they left this guy behind. He's like...
Here's your help, sir.
You need my help?
You say, where's my truck?
Where'd my truck? Look at that guy's face. Hey, where are you going? I was looking at your face.
Peter Jessen asks...
What's up, Peter?
Asked us, or Brad specifically, if we've ever played...
Brad's here?
Brother? No, I don't think so. Asked if we played Brothers, A Tales of Two Sons.
Yes, I played it a long time ago. It's been a while. I've not picked it up since it kind of first came out. Mm. Great game. Yeah. I actually played it solo. I didn't play it co-op. But I heard it is fun co-op. Did you play it?
No?
It's one of those ones that tugs at your heartstrings. It really does. Made me cry a little bit inside. And outside. No, I don't think I physically cried. I'm not against it.
Heavy on
I'm just saying, yeah. Luis did.
Covenant has located and secured the Pillar of Autumn's crash site.
Good, gentlemen.
The good news is the captain's still alive.
Hey, thanks, Luis.
Thanks, Luis.
See you later, you dirty console player.
Let's hurry and find
yes, definitely. So I think I'm supposed to go back to this other area again. This was definitely one of the more confusing maps. I think I'm just going to drive around in circles.
So, Adam, you know,
yeah,
I haven't played PC games in a long time, a very, very long time. I was like, the one game I probably played a lot back in my days would probably be Counter-Strike.
Yeah.
So now that I'm trying to get back into PC gaming.
1.7?
Pretty much, yeah. very first one. So it's like, what should I start playing? Or people in the live chat, what any recommendations?
If I
had like, you know, like maybe four hours on a weekend, you know, 4 or 5 hours.
You're saying what's the quintessential PC game?
Yes, that I should just sit down and just play it.
I mean, I would call
Metro
a quintessential PC game. I mean, you can play it on console, but I mean, that's Metro. Like, it's perfect on. It's made for PC. It's perfect on PC, especially if you have the hardware and can do the RTX stuff. I bet people will joke Crysis, but
yeah.
I don't think it holds up. I don't think you can go back. Also, I don't think I'm supposed to go back. Where is this? What? Oh. Oh, look, there's a little red arrow. I think that's where I'm supposed to go. Yeah, I'm curious. Oh, there. Oh, okay. It's on the map. Thank you.
People are saying Crysis 3 is...
You know what's
the
weird?
The better of the two.
Between Crysis 1, 2, and 3?
Yeah.
I can't remember. I played both 2 and 3. I don't remember which one I liked more. I mean, both of them... All three of them, the story blew chunks. I'm a story guy. I like good story. Mm-hmm. The combat's good. I mean, but Crysis is definitely like another quintessential PC thing. Mm-hmm. I mean, are you into like StarCraft, like RTS, like something you literally couldn't really play on a console?
Yeah.
I mean, hey, Dan was a big StarCraft player. You could play with him.
All right.
There's actually a base building game like that that's kind of Dan got into pretty hardcore called They Are Billions. I think there's a console version, but it's obviously better on PC with the mouse and keyboard support. But the They Are Billions is kind of like a nice PC one. It's hard because I don't really delineate between console and PC. You know, it's just like, hey, it's a good game. It's hard to really be like, oh, well, this is definitely a better PC game.
So you play for the story?
I'm definitely a story.
Story guy?
Yeah. Oh, what are you doing down here, buddy?
Roger that. Marines, assemble for evac. Pronto!
Pronto! Oh, the music kicking in.
That's the last of them. Roger that. I'm on my way.
What? Okay.
New traffic on the Covenant battle net.
Uh-oh.
I found Captain Keyes. He's being held on a... The Truth and Reconciliation. A ship I disabled before we abandoned the auto.
Oh, weird. Quintessential PC games. Anyone else have any more suggestions on quintessential PC games?
Quintessential PC games. Age of Empires.
Oh, yeah. Another one. RTS. Can't really play on console. But also, I never got into RTS. Hayden was a huge fan. Yeah. I mean, there's a new one I really do want to play. There we go. Sweet. I haven't been able to... picked up yet. I'm waiting on a sale. Is Hayden gave it Game of the Year last year for PC World. It's Point and Click Adventure. Oh my god, I can't think of his name. Wow, that's really that bugs me. I can't think of it.
The enemy has captured Captain Keyes.
Just Google PC World Game of the Year 2019. Like that one, I actually don't think has any console versions.
There's a gravity lift that various troops and supplies.
But like a CRPG are always better on PC. Like,
lock on to the tracking signal from Captain Key's neural implants.
I've been.
You forgot which one?
Get him, Marines! Go, go, go! The Corps ain't paying.
The game he gave Game of the Year.
I've detected Covenant station.
Oh, and I hate this level.
I recommend using your sniper rifle to take out the gunners while I call for Marine support.
Were you able to find it?
No.
PC World Game of the Year 2019.
Got the 10 best PC games of 2019?
Yeah. So he awards a top one, and then all the rest are like bottom. Like, he doesn't go 1 through 10, he just says what's number 1, and then the rest. Oh, man. It's hard to think and shoot at the same time. But, man, once you say it, I'm gonna be like, oh yeah, duh, what the hell was I thinking? But there's another one by Larian Studios, and I can't think of that game either. That's one I definitely want to play. It's a Baldur's Gate kind of game. You can't find it?
Yeah, so he has Resident Evil 2,
yep,
Heaven's
on there.
Vault,
keep
Control,
going. Yep.
Planet Zoo,
yep.
Baba is You,
yep.
Hypnospace
Outlaw, yep. Keep going.
What else do we got? We got Metro Exodus,
yeah,
Observation, Outer Wilds, and then, okay, here you go, best game of 2019, Disco Elysium.
That's what it is, okay. Weird name, but it's a CRPG, point and click, you know, you're going through a lot of dialogue options. That kind of game, I definitely think is like quintessential PC. But yeah, look up Larian Studios, they're... They just announced they're working on Baldur's Gate 3, but before that they came out with 1 and 2 of something else. And I've been meaning to play. I have it. I've just been meaning to play it.
Like what game they have?
Yeah, just list off the games that they make.
Let's see. Divine Divinity?
Oh, yeah, Divinity Original Sin 2. Ah. That's one that... There are console releases of it. Mm-hmm. And actually, you know what? I do want to buy the Switch version of it, because it has cross-play functionality between Switch and PC. So it's like, you know, maybe I could play a little bit on the bus ride, and then... When I go home, the cloud save loads, and I can just play it on the PC.
Nice.
Oh, another one, I'd say Witcher 3. Have you played Witcher 3?
Not yet. I want to get into that, though, too.
You know what? It was funny. It took me a long time. I tried to start Witcher 3, like, so many times, and just, like, it never stuck with me. And everyone was always just like, Witcher 3, Witcher 3. And, like, then I finally got into it on the Switch because of the portable nature of it. Like, I like my RPGs portable. It's hard for me to sit down for a long RPG.
And in terms of graphics, like, you don't mind that. You just want to have the mobile mobility, the gameplay.
I mean, I do. I do. I tell you what, man. Oh, boy. The Switch version is rough. It's rough. But, I mean, the fact that it's even running on a Switch is, like, impressive. Like, part of it, you know, is like, okay, it looks like crap. But the fact they got it to run on it is enough to be like, wow, this is cool to see that. But also, man, the story is just so good. Mm. Like once it finally, like, dug my teeth into it, like, the story was just so good. And I was like, okay, now I understand why people, like, just rave about it. And I'm like, halfway through Blood and Wine, which is one of their expansions. Yeah, Leif actually reviewed the expansions for IGN.
No.
It was funny. I was looking up reviews for the expansions and to see if I should play both or if I should just play Blood and Wine. Because I know that one was good, but I didn't know about the other one. I can't remember the name of it off the top of my head. Surprise, surprise. And then I was like, oh, that's funny. IGN's review is from Leif Johnson. Our very own Macworld's very own Leif Johnson, who... came on the Full Nerd to talk about GeForce Now. Yes, he used to be a freelance games writer and wrote for everybody, including IGN.
Oh, Peter is asking if you enjoy playing Deus Ex Human Revolution.
Oh, man, you know, that's another series that I've always had a hard time getting into. I've had both Human Revolution and Mankind Divided, and I've tried to play both of them on and off here and there, but... I don't know. It's just another one that, for some reason, it wouldn't stick with me. And I hate to say it. If it came out on Switch, who knows? Maybe that's like, maybe I just really need to play things portably.
Everything needs to be made to Switch.
Yeah, that aren't first-person shooters. Though I will say, I did pick up Metro Last Light on the Switch because it just barely came out. And you know what? It actually doesn't look that bad on the Switch. Yeah. I mean, come on. Compared to a high-end PC, of course, it's going to, you know, look inferior. But on the Switch, I'm like, wow, they did some work to this. Like, how the hell did they get this to run on the Switch? The problem for me on the Switch is the built-in thumbsticks are just not good.
Oh, yeah.
They're horrible, especially for first-person shooters. Yeah. So, like, that's the worst part of trying to play on the Switch is the thumbsticks.
Yeah.
I mean, for most games it's fine, but for first-person shooters it's just like pulling my teeth out.
Yeah. I tried playing Overwatch on it and just didn't feel right.
Yeah. I mean, it's cool that you can, you know? And, hey, you know, like, that's why I like the whole cross-save thing. Like, actually, the cross-save stuff just came to Witcher 3 on the Switch, where you can sync with your Steam cloud saves. The problem is I haven't been able to sync it. There's this weird bug that just says, like, upload failed, and I can't upload my save from the Switch to the PC. Mm. But, like, being able to be like, hey, you know what, I'm going to play a little bit on the bus, so, you know, I can kind of keep advancing the story or work on something small. But then being able, when I get home, to plug it in and play it on a PC, like, I think it's awesome. I think we live in a pretty cool time.
Yeah, absolutely.
And at the end of the day, you know, like, PC is definitely my preferred platform, but I like games. I like playing good games.
As long as it's a good game, it doesn't matter.
You know, I've liked plenty of bad games too, I'll admit. I'm not against a good bad game.
What's a really bad game that you really like to play?
Well, I would say there back when I was younger and had way more time than money, and not much going on. I remember I picked up this game for the PlayStation 1 called what was it called? I don't even remember. It was a top-down shooter like Ikaruga, like a bullet hell kind of game. And it was so bad. It had it was Freedom Force or something like that. Nah, I don't know. And it had three ladies on the front and who had nothing to do with the game. It was just it was so bad, but man, I played a lot of that game. I don't know why. I think because it was funny, partially, just be like, oh my god, look how bad this game is. I'm going to keep playing it. Isn't that funny? Back when I had a lot of time.
Back when, you know.
Yeah, now I'm like, you know what? I should probably limit the amount of games I try to play and just focus on the good ones. As I've gotten older, I definitely have gotten to that point where I'm like, if I'm not enjoying a game within, a couple hours, I'm like, all right, F it. Move on to the next one. I got plenty of games.
I remember playing, since we're talking about bad games.
Yeah, what about you?
Have you played Pepsi Man on PlayStation 1?
Mm-hmm. But it is funny that both of our first thoughts are of the PS1.
The PS1. It's what the equivalent of today's mobile games, like those, like Minion Rush, those games where it's just you...
Like
you
tower swipe. Defense kind of thing?
Yeah, or the character's already just running on a platform and you just swipe up to jump platforms or sliding down, basically avoiding obstacles and whatnot. And Pepsi Man was on the PlayStation 1. I had it just because I was like, oh, Pepsi Man?
You're like, oh, it's Pepsi.
Yeah.
Back when licensed games, they were just shitting them out. Yeah, Pepsi Man.
I got it for $3. I was like, okay, it's just a $3 game.
I mean, back in the day, God, I remember you used to, go rolling into GameStop when they would have the buy two, get one free for sales. Mm-hmm. And just find I was like, okay, if I can at least get two, $30 games, or two $20 games or whatever, two $30 games, let's say that, and then I could get three games for the price of one brand new game. So that's actually back when I was trying to build a collection. That was the early days. That's how I kind of tried to build up my collection, was just collecting a bunch of so games. Man, another one that popped up in my head was oh, what's that open world? Mercenaries. Oh, man. You ever play Mercenaries?
Oh, I know it, though.
Mercenaries 2 was cool, but Mercenaries 1, oh, that was one of the first Xbox games I had. And I remember reading EGM and having it talk about, how much better it was on the Xbox and having, side-by-side images. So I was like, all right, I'll pick it up with the Xbox version. Yeah, that was not a good game. I mean, it wasn't a bad game. It was just a middling game,
Right.
I feel like we had a lot more middling games back in the day.
Have they had any more games out? Because there was Mercenaries 2, or 1 and 2.
Yeah, they had Mercenaries 1 and 2. I don't know if that might have been the same team that went on to make Just Cause.
By
I think that might be the same team.
Pandemic Solutions?
Yeah, I think it is. Or no.
Oh, no, but you said Just Cause?
Yeah.
No. So they made Star Wars Battlefront 2 in 2005, and then the latest one, they haven't made a game since 2009, Saboteur.
Oh, Saboteur. Yeah, I remember that game. I remember because it was like, ooh, this game has boobies. Ooh, my goodness.
Adam.
It was like... People bought it because it had boobies, and then you actually play it, and it's just like, oh, it's a horrible GTA clone. Okay, it wasn't horrible. Horrible's exaggerating. It was just boring. A boring GTA clone. Along those same lines, do you remember Mafia 3?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Or all the Mafias.
All the Mafias.
Yeah, like, just like, you want to talk about GTA clone. Oh. Though I have heard some people, like, speak fondly of Mafia 3.
I enjoyed it. I enjoyed Mafia 3. It wasn't, like, great. It wasn't, like, you know, it wasn't GTA for sure, but it was still, you know, a decent open world.
I mean, but it's like those open world games, you pretty much, you know, like, you would dump a lot of, those games are meant to be, like, dumped a lot of hours into, yeah. Right? And so it's like, man, can you believe we used to spend that much time on that game? Like, that game did not deserve, I don't know how long you played it, but it's like games like Mercenaries 1. I probably put a good 40 hours into it, and that was not worth my time. Not worth my time. And I didn't even do everything. But then again, I've always been kind of somebody to, like, move around from game to game. Like, that's why things like Counter-Strike have never really appealed to me, because it's like the only way to get good at it is, like, you have to keep playing it. Mm-hmm. Like, you can't just, like, play it here, play it there. You know, it's just like, no, you got to have a group. You got to team up. You got to practice. You got to play it. And I'm like, yeah, I've always been like, you know, oh, I want to go play this. All right, go play this. Let's go try this. Oh, you know what? I'd rather just beat this again. I've beaten a lot of games multiple times. And I would rather do that with my time than, like, dump, you know, thousands of hours into a game like CSGO. Mm. Not that I haven't done that. I mean, like League, I definitely went through, like, a good 6-month period where I played a lot of League of Legends. Mm-hmm. You know, but then again, it was getting to that point where I was like, all right, I should probably, you know, team up, get some teammates. Like, you know, if I want to get better, I need to dedicate more time in my life to it. And I was like, eh, I'd rather go play an RPG, or I'd rather go play a first-person shooter. That's why I like Call of Duty, because it's always a good, like, palate cleanser. Mm-hmm. Like, it's like, you know what, I get it every year, play it for eight and play the single player, you know, for like 8 hours, and it's like, all right, that was cool. Maybe play the multiplayer for, you know, a couple dozen hours, and then be like, all right, cool. That was cool. I did it.
Yeah.
I don't need to dedicate all my life to it. Though Modern Warfare, I definitely did put my fair share of time into Modern Warfare.
Modern Warfare.
The original Modern Warfare.
Ah, okay.
Not the newest one. Not the reboot. Though I do want to go back to it, because it has a new, or I don't know if it's come out yet, but it has the new Battle Royale mode.
No.
I like a good boy, Battle Royale. Bad games. Yep. I remember I played a lot of Need for Speed Underground. I like Need for Speed back in the day.
Yeah.
A lot of racing games. Oh, man, Burnout Paradise.
That I haven't played.
That was... Oh, you never played? I mean, it probably doesn't hold up, but Burnout Paradise, that was, like, man, formative driving game. God, I love Burnout Paradise. I played that. Oh, and that's one of those good ones where it's, like, it got re-released and, like, up-rezzed, and I bought it just, you know, to have the updated version. And I probably played it for a couple hours and was like, all right, that's cool. I did it. I checked it out. They up-rezzed it. It's a great game. But I don't know. I like collections. I like having a digital collection rather than a physical collection. It's a lot easier to collect digitally.
Yeah. But for me, if I have a physical, I don't necessarily collect it. I would just play it.
Trade it in.
Not even just trade, or, you know, just sell it.
Sell it. That's what I meant.
On eBay. Yeah.
That's very economical of you.
I started to realize that when...
Actually, I used to do that too.
Yeah. I had a way... Back then, I had way too many PlayStation 2 games.
Yeah, me too.
And I was just like, oh... And I can't really sell a whole lot of it anymore. So I was like, oh, what am I going to, you know, do with it? And then as I got onto PlayStation 3 and 4, I was like, okay, I'm just going to play one game. Like, I'm going to beat it real quick and then sell it ASAP, because then at least, you know, if I beat it within like 3 to 4 months, I can still retain value.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like, I'm not going to lose a lot of money, but, you know, I'll use that, you know, bit of money and buy the next game. You know?
See, I was never an eBay person. I was always take it.
Oh man,
I was always take it to GameStop. You know, especially like if they had a deal. Sometimes they'd have deals where they're like, "Hey, you know, we'll give you an extra trade-in bonus credit. You know, if you trade three games, we'll give you 10% extra. If you trade in four games, we'll give you 20% extra." You know, like right. So I would try to maximize those. Yeah, that's actually, and then yeah, when I decided I was finally gonna get rid of my collection because I just hated, like, I didn't want to transport it. I move around so much. I was like, all right. So yeah, I traded in my first batch of like PS2 games on some sort of like GameStop deal.
Right.
I can't remember how many games I traded in, but it was quite a few. It was probably a good five dozen, something like that. I got like $1,200.
$1,200?
Yeah, wow. So I was able to get, and a lot of these were old crappy games, but you know, I try to maximize it, and that's how I got my 360. And then a bunch of games. By trading them in. And then I had, like rare games. Like, those, you know, so I traded in the games that I was like, I don't have any attachment to it. I don't care. It's just bulk, you know. As cool as it would be to have a big library, it's not worth it. You know, and then slowly over time, I started trading the ones where I was like, okay, well, I don't have any sentimental attachment to this, but I have, you know, it's like worth something. So I traded those in. And then even to a point where I got to like the sentimental ones and I was like, you know, I can get this on PC or I can emulate it now, like easy. So yeah, that's how I ended up just like trading in all that stuff. I mean, all in all, I probably traded in. I mean, I had a couple like Super Nintendo games that were like sealed in box, like Chrono Trigger, stuff like that.
Oh, Chrono Trigger.
Like nothing that was like super expensive. I can't remember like the thing that I had that was like worth the most. But yeah, I got a good amount of money from trades. So no more trading on the PC, but that's okay because you can get games just so damn cheap. Like, the sales are way more liberal on Steam and PC than console.
That's what I noticed. That's why I'm trying to... I'm interested in getting back to PC, because then I realized, wow, the games I would find on discount are usually on PC. You know, even if, you know, they have both platforms on PlayStation or PC, PC will always have, like, 20%... is 20% cheaper.
Got it. The door's open. Everyone should move through now.
It's great.
I can't guarantee that it won't lock again when it closes.
How's the stream holding up? The quality still okay? I'm glad I got that CPU thing figured out.
Still looking pretty good.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
And I did put it to high quality mode, so we're getting a little bit of a lag between the video feed coming in and in the chat, but it's not like Full Nerd where we're, you know, taking live questions and stuff.
Any upcoming PC game you're looking forward to that's being released the next few months or the year?
I mean, I've never been good at like watching release schedules, so honestly, I don't even know what's coming up. I mean, I'm pretty excited for Cyberpunk. That's going to be damn awesome. I know at some point they're going to have some expansions for Control. Man, I love Control. Favorite game of last year, that's for damn sure.
Yeah, we'll need to play that too.
I mean, if you can play that with ray tracing, which is only on the PC, obviously. If you can play it with ray tracing, like, that definitely makes a huge difference, especially for somebody who loves lighting.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that was like a game changer. I mean, it's still an amazing game on its own, but the ray tracing just adds that little extra.
Nice.
Go, 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 go. Where are we going? Where are we going, guys?
Yeah. Anthony Williams says Half-Life is coming this month.
Oh, yeah, Half-Life Alyx, yeah. How much have you messed around in VR?
not that much.
I mean, hey, you want to talk about another quintessential PC thing? I mean, PlayStation VR is out there, but it's, yeah, it's, compared to what's on PC, it's, yeah, it's more like a kid's toy. But yeah, Half-Life Alyx, man, that bumps me out because my old space, you'd been by old space, mm-hmm, man, my old space had a lot of room for VR, like room scale VR, yes, just to, like, to be able to just like move around to like and set up VR. That was pretty nice. Mm. I definitely don't have that kind of space, but luckily we do have our Macworld set, our living room studio. Like we have the Vive hooked up. So I think what I'll probably do is get the game and then just play it like, you know, half an hour at the end of work every day or something.
Yeah.
I'm excited, yeah. Half-Life, there we go. That's another quintessential PC series. Have you ever played Half-Life?
Yes, I have.
Which ones? Two?
Two.
Oh, okay, yeah. Really, I love Half-Life 2. Did you play the episodes as well?
No.
Yeah, because Half-Life 2, Episode 1 and 2 are, you know, the final ones that they made. Half-Life Alyx is a prequel to 2. But, you know, who knows? Maybe there'll be some little teasers in there. I don't know. I don't think they'll ever make a 3, but yeah. I was going to say, if you hadn't played Half-Life 2, you know what? You should... I think it's worth going back and playing Half-Life 2. I try to play it every couple years. Half-Life 2, and then if you've never played the episodes, you should definitely play the episodes. And, dude, you can get all the Half-Life games for, like, $2 on a Steam sale. Like, anytime there's a Steam sale, Half-Life is just, like, pennies.
I'll keep my eye on it.
Yeah, no, it's great. Episode 2 especially. I liked Episode 2 a lot. Episode 1 was okay, but 2 is just... Oh, no! Woo! Woo-hoo, boy! Ooh, doggy.
Our chat's chiming in. There's Doom Eternal, Death Stranding.
Oh,
well.
Doom. Death Stranding is not out on the PC yet.
Not yet, but someone's excited for it to come out soon.
I mean, I'll probably buy it again on PC. I mean, we should stream it when it comes out.
Oh, yeah.
That's for damn sure. I already beat it. I probably won't. I definitely won't go through it again. I went through it once. It's enough for me. Doom, yeah. Have you played any of the Dooms?
I haven't played the classics.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, like the recent ones.
Mm-hmm. Oh, not the recent ones.
Yeah, so Doom 2016, and then, yeah, Doom Eternal, which is coming out. Oh, man, Doom Eternal. Wait, Doom Eternal is coming out soon. Yeah. Hell yeah. I forgot they delayed it last year. Oh, hell yeah. There we go. That's a game I'm looking forward to. Hell yeah. And, yeah, Doom 2016, that was probably my favorite game of 2016. Like, and that's like awesome on PC because you can just push it, you can just crank it, and it runs actually really well on even low-end machines.
Yeah,
like, and it's just like just balls to the wall, fast-paced first person shooter action. Oh man, yeah, Doom Eternal, very excited for that. But Doom 2016, I mean, I bought it and played through it again on the Switch, even though it looked and ran like dump on the Switch. And I played through it again on PC. So I played through it like 3 or 4 times, probably. Yeah, what a good game. You can get it on the console. I mean, that's definitely one you can get on the console and be fine. But yeah, it's obviously the prettiest on PC, so... I'd call it a quintessential PC game.
All right. Got a lot on my list then. Oh boy.
Yeah,
not
get cracking.
Time. Not enough time.
Well, you know what you should do? You should just make it a series for PC World.
Play it at work.
Yeah, hey, I mean, you know. We usually when we're doing streams, we, you know, we look at something new or like something updated, but I've always wanted to do like just like a stream, you know, a multi-part stream and be like, all right, you know what, we're, you know, in the next couple weeks we're just gonna go through Half-Life 2, should beat it all over again. Oh man, I can't stick him. Got it. No.
Oh.
I didn't die for a while. Oh, look at that butt. Oops, nope. Yeah, I'm getting used to the Steam controller.
Yeah,
still feel like I could probably get the sensitivity up. So then I have to do less, like, Whoa! Get out of my face, bro!
Jumping at you.
There we go.
Nice.
Oh no, I'm on sliver health. Wait, why do I still have the sniper rifle? Yeah, I can probably turn the sensitivity up and be fine. There's still so much to... There's literally, like, so many settings and things you can adjust in the Steam controller. Like, it's nuts. Like, it even has, like, gyroscope control if you wanted to, do that. Where am I supposed to go? I think I'm supposed to let these guys out. How do I do that? Huh. Come on out! I thought I was supposed to go to this panel. Oh yeah.
Yeah, me then. There it is.
There it is.
Look, a Mark V.
Coming here. Oh, you know you can't switch between classic and new in cutscene. That's funny.
No.
Oh, look at these frame rates I'm getting. 430 frames a second.
Wow.
Your weapons. Let's be ready to
bandwidth move. Limited my yes. butt.
Adam, what mode are you playing right now? People are asking, easy mode or legendary?
Oh, no, it's just on normal.
Normal.
Yeah, just on normal.
People are like, oh, is Adam on easy right now?
Hey, hey, hey. I'm not afraid to say when I play games on easy. I play a lot of games on easy. Sometimes I just, especially story-based games, I'm like, you know what, I'd rather just see the story, play through it, play it on easy.
Are you using, like, gyro aim?
Not on this, no.
Not on this.
I did try to configure it when I first, like, set it up to, like, test the setup, but it wasn't feeling right. I still am not getting fully used to the gyro aim, because the problem I have, like, especially in a setup like this, I don't have, like, full gyro movement. You know, I'd have to, like, pick my forearms up, mm-hmm. right, you know? I mean, I think the idea is that you do, like, fine movements, but I can do fine movements, like, tilting front and back, but I can't do fine movements, like, left and right. I have to literally pick my hand up off the thing, and it just doesn't feel right. If I was gaming like this, that makes more sense, because, you know, it's kind of cradling in my lap, but...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Peter says you should play Cuphead.
Oh, no. No, thank you. I know my limits. Cuphead is just not for me. I can appreciate it from a distance.
We should play it together.
You? Have you played it?
I have.
Oh.
I love the graphics, just the way it kind of,
animates.
Animates and kind of mimic the classic Disney style.
No, I totally get it. It's a beautiful game. But, yeah, it's not
tough
for me.
It's tough. It's a tough game, though.
I mean, like I said, back in the day, like, when I had the time, man, yeah, I would dedicate plenty of hours to games that just were relentless and kicked your butt over and over again just to master them. I remember I had a friend. I was never into it, but I had a friend who was big into Beautiful Joe. And man, yeah, he just played the hell out of that game, and it would just destroy him. Yeah, I mean, I don't. It's funny, you know. I don't play games for like a skill challenge anymore. To be like, oh, look how much skill I have. It's more like I want a good story. I want, like, you know, pretty graphics. Like, I wanted to play good, but, like, I think that's also why, like, Counter-Strike never appealed to me, because I'm just like, I'm not trying to, like, make myself the best player awesome, you know, ever. I just want to play some games. It's an escape for me. Wait, I think I already... Did I already go this way? I'm definitely... I don't know where I'm going. This guy's following me, so hopefully he's following me for a reason. I think I'm going the wrong way. Oh, wait, I see this guy. Look at that. There's two of them. One, two. Easy.
Cortana to Echo 419. We have okay. the captain and the extraction on the double. Negative, Cortana. I've been engaged by Covenant Air Patrols. And
I'm escorting the captain. Okay.
You'll be better off finding your own ride.
So I'm going the right way.
Acknowledged, Foehammer. Cortana.
Acknowledged, foe hammer.
Just waiting.
We need to hold here until she can move in.
Oh, okay.
Oh, hold the fort.
We're trapped in here. We're screwed. We're screwed.
Game over, man. Game over.
Remember, you're 11. Cortana.
Classic. We'll beat this level and then we'll tune out.
Yes, Captain. There's a Covenant dropship still docked.
I think we're pretty close to the end. Oh, music's kicking in. All right, the door unlocked. Oh, that's my guy. I saw movement and I shot.
You just shot your own guy.
Whoops. What? Sorry. Come on, Marines. You know, I at one point in my life, I did read a Halo book. I can't remember which one I read, but I did.
Halo book.
I was a nerd. Halo doesn't have, like, exquisite lore, but it's not bad. It's cheesy sci-fi. I can get behind a good cheesy sci-fi. Oh, wait. Weird. Okay.
Since you read Halo, did you read The Witcher?
The dropship is loose.
No, never read Witcher, never read Metro. No, I mean, this was back in the day. This was early 2000s, mid 2000s. When Halo was the big rage, man.
Captain Hunter.
Oh no!
Hang on.
Hang on. Oh my goodness.
Nice one, sir.
Did he?
Little payback.
Was he? Did he squish them? They didn't really show it.
No.
They're like, you know, it's implied. We squished him. Nice. Cool. I did it. Oh, look, I got another achievement.
Nice.
Complete. Oh, that was weird. Complete truth and reconciliation with a sniper rifle, I think. Still in my loadout. I think that's what it said.
The Covenant believe that what they call the silent cartographer.
Oh, yeah, this is a good level. This is one of my favorite levels, probably, because you get a lot of warthog combat.
The island has multiple
structures and installations. And these cutscenes are a little choppy. Yeah. Ah, the handgun, classic. Oh, the music. Yeah, it just swells. Let's turn this up for a second.
It's a good soundtrack.
Oh, it's an awesome soundtrack. Martin Wood. Martin. Shit, what was his name? Martin something. Martin O'Donnell. That's what it is.
O'Donnell.
Yeah. Fire in the hole. One of my favorite little beaches. All right, cool.
Were the cutscenes, are they locked at 30 frames or just the way it's running?
No, those were unlocked, and that's why they're jittery, because they were probably rendered out at 30, but then we uncapped them. Yeah, it's not a separate setting, I don't think. But it's probably tied to VSync or the frame rate limit.
Yeah, we got our live chat asking about the cutscenes getting a little choppy.
Yeah, right. It's not great. I think it's just because it's not built to be unlocked. Mm. I mean, I usually use VSync anyway for even gameplay, but I have VSync off just so we can see the uncapped frame rate, see what this 2070 can push. All right, well, now that I got my warthog, I'm happy. I think we end it there, Willis. We end it with some warthogging around in the sandy beaches of
epic soundtrack.
Truth and Reconciliation. Anyway. Thanks for joining me, Willis. This was fun.
Anytime.
Did you have fun?
Oh, love it.
Is this the most you've ever watched somebody play Halo?
Well, next time you can let me play Halo.
Yeah, next time we should partner up. We should do split screen. Actually, yeah. I wonder if the PC version even has split screen.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering too. Like, that is a good question. Screen?
I don't see why not. I mean, it is the full. It's supposed to be the full version of the Master Chief Collection, but then again, not many people split screen on a PC. It's not really designed for that. So I don't know. Maybe it's there. Maybe it's not.
We'll test it out next time.
Yeah. But I will say between the release of Reach and the Combat Evolved, which is this one, it was only about 3 months. So if we get a new Halo every 3 months until we fill out the Master Chief Collection, I'll be excited. I'll be happy about that. But unfortunately, they'll probably get to ODST last, and that'll make me sad. Or it's a good one to end on. I liked ODST. yeah, alright. I just can't play it. I can't stop playing. It's just a comfortable game to play. You just sit there, mindlessly zone out, talk. I'm really good at just blabbering, you know. My gums hitting my mouth, my teeth. Blah, blah, blah. Just talking. Alright. cool. Alright. All right. I'm gonna put it down. I'm done.
He's done.
I'm done.
All right.
Thank you, everybody, for joining. Thank you, Willis, for you know, dealing with the chat and the verticals and horizontals. And thank you to Halo for staying in our hearts and minds ever since 2001. Almost 20 years ago.
Right.
Yeah. No. Yeah. Yeah.
Just about.
Wow. Crazy. Anyway, not sure about a full nerd stream this week, but hopefully we're going to get to it at some point. But if people are sick, then we won't do it. Or maybe I'll just do a stream by myself and Brad.
Brad, wait, yeah,
we'll see.
Brad.
Half nerd with me and Brad.
All right.
Other than that, we do have some fun stuff next week. Probably a live build coming up sometime soon, and we'll probably stream some more games. I want to test this EGP further too, and the Steam controller. So anyway, thanks everyone for tuning in. Have a good rest of your day and rest of your week.